Hey, what's up, fellas? How you doing? Matt Antonelli here.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? How we doing? Answering your questions today. Today's question is, what is my worst baseball injury during my career? I've had a lot of them, like a real lot of them. I've talked to you guys about some of them before. I've had, you know, 3 hand and wrist surgeries. I've hurt my hamstring really bad and missed months. I've hurt my knee and missed months. I've pretty much done everything that I possibly could to hurt myself and to miss games. I missed probably about half my professional games because of injury, which is pretty bad. I've had, this isn't an injury, but I got the swine flu 1 year and was basically quarantined away from off in the hotel room, away from my team, me and my bro. There was 8 of us all together, but I had that. We missed like 22 games that time. So that was not an injury, but something else bad that happened to me. So all these bad things happened to me during my career. But my worst injury was in college. I was playing at Wake Forest and playing third base. Freshman year, there's a high fly ball hit. The wind's blowing about 50 miles an hour. It was one of the windiest days probably that I played in college. So the ball's hit, it's hit basically to me at third base. I start calling it, but the wind was blowing so hard that way that it just starts kind of like running away from me. So I'm running and I'm running and I'm like, oh, like this ball, I can't get to this ball. It kept going that way. The catcher realizes that the ball's coming back at him. So he starts sprinting out and he had one of those hockey masks on. So he's running this way and I'm full speed this way. And I have no idea that he's coming hard at me. And I go to catch the ball and I'm running, like at this point, I'm running full speed. I'm on a sprint and he's on a sprint. And we smash face to face. He's got a helmet on, I don't. So I go down and I probably got a concussion. I'm not really sure. This was 2004. So this is before like concussions were kind of a big deal. So I just remember laying on the ground and like I kind of get up and I don't know what the hell's going on. And like, I kind of figure it out and I'm like, all right, I'm okay. I felt okay. And they're like, no, you're not okay. So they brought me into the dugout. And I didn't realize until I sat down, there was blood like coming all over me. And like, they're all holding my face. And I feel okay. I don't feel anything. I'm fine. And they're like, you're not going back in the game today. So they had to bring me right down to the hospital and stitch me up. I ended up with 30 stitches. I got sliced. So the bars on the helmet, one sliced me here, one sliced me here, which I don't know if you can see when I smile sometimes, but this side or this side, I can't remember. When I smile, I get like 2 dimples on one side. I think it might be this side. Although I've got my beard, so it makes it harder to see the scars. Here, here, and then one went down like this. So sliced me in 3 spots, end up getting like 30 something stitches, I think. Back then when I was tougher, I didn't miss anything. So I got to play. I actually got to play with the stitches in. I felt kind of like a badass. I had the stitches here, here, and here. But it was my worst injury by far. I mean, you know, I have permanent everything else. Like, you know, I've got scars and stuff on my hand. And my hand still hurts from it and gets sore sometimes. But that was the scariest one because I remember when I got the stitches and then the game was over. It happened like towards the end of the game. By the time I came back, the game was already over. I went back to my dorm room afterwards. Let me tell this first and I'll tell that. And I looked in the mirror and it looked like, I thought my face was going to be like all mangled. You might still think it looks mangled, but you know, it just looked like kind of gross. And I was like, oh my God, I just like, basically I'm going to look like Two-Face from Batman. But you can't really even tell anymore. Like, you can't even see these ones down here. And this one you only see when I smile. I keep thinking it's this side. I can't remember if it's this side or this side. But you can only see it when I smile and you don't even notice. It almost looks like just another dimple on my face, I guess. So, turned out okay, but was probably my worst injury. And my parents had flown in to town to watch me play. And my girlfriend did at the time. And They were probably more scared than I was because I'd never been hurt before. My dad always says, like, oh, you never, when he got knocked down, he always just jumped right back up. I still feel like I jumped back up, but honestly, I don't know where the hell I was. I might have rolled around on the ground for like 3 minutes. I don't really remember, but I feel like I jumped right back up. And I actually, for the first time, made the news. My dad, they were flying out after the game, so they went to the airport, and they said that they were sitting in the terminal, and it showed it up on the news. It showed me, like, getting crushed. Getting destroyed by the catcher. And and my catcher, JB Tucker, I don't know if he'll ever watch it. He might watch this, I don't know. I can't remember what he said to me. What did he say? I think he might have pulled the major league line that said, stay off the tracks when the train's coming through, butthead. He said something like that. So he was not very sensitive about my face, but I've recovered, so no problem, JB. I feel good. Anyways, that was my worst injury in my experience, because I thought my face was blown off and going to be impact me for life and kill my modeling career and all that good stuff that happened down the road. So that's all I got, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate it. Thanks for sending in the questions. Subscribe to the channel if you're not done so already. Give us a thumbs up. Share the video with all your friends. Check out the description box below. I've got a bunch of stuff down there for you guys to check out as well. And take care, everybody. Thanks again. We'll see you.